happening. Mumbai has had to urbanize rapidly to cope with the growing population, and some areas have, as always, developed faster than others, leading to unequal levels of infrastructure and connectivity. Now, what's happening? The Maharashtra government is trying to correct that by building growth centers to promote equal development, and the first growth center has been planned in Kalyan. How will this affect development here, and will this become a realty hotspot? Nikhil Narayan Sivdas has this report.
The increasing pressure on Mumbai's land and housing may soon find an outlet, with the Mumbai Metropolitan Development Authority, or MMRDA, announcing its plans to build a growth centre in Kalyan.
We have identified around 1,089 hectares of land, which would be developed as a growth centre. So we have developed, prepared a kind of master plan for that area, and we would be acquiring that land either directly or through town planning scheme, whereby the landowners also become partners in the process. And then the area shall be developed, infrastructure will be developed in that area.
Kalyan is the first among a series of growth centers planned across the Mumbai metropolitan region. The government is hoping that development of this area will have spillover effects on the surrounding regions of Ambernath, Ulhasnagar and Dombivali. As a first step, the government is focused on bringing in big business by developing the area as a commercial hub, a move that is expected to bring a radical change to the demographics of the Kalyan Dombivali belt.
The demand drivers are basically unorganized industrial units in the periphery of Kalyan, like Ambernath, Ulhasnagar, so on and so forth. We would expect that this mix of demography will change, and there will be different type of demand for for residential apartments, probably catering to middle and middle high income gentry.
The Kalyan Dombivali belt has always seen buyer interest thanks to its affordability. Prices here average around 5,000 rupees per square feet compared to 10,000 rupees per square feet in neighboring Thane. But absorption has been low, with buyers put off by the distance and a lack of connectivity. However, with a growth center on the cards, infrastructural development will be on top of the agenda, and that will be a windfall for developers such as the Lodha Group, the Runwal Group and Nirmal Lifestyle, among others, who have significant residential projects in the region.
In the last 10 years, major outskirts development of Mumbai has happened in Thane. I see the same thing happening with Kalyan Dombivali. If we are able to create an ecosystem jahan pe jobs bhi logon ke paas wahi hai, there are jobs in that region and there is good quality residential housing in that region, that is ideal for that region.
Land acquisition for the growth center is to start next year. However, the biggest concern for experts is the amount of time the MMRDA will take to develop the region.
The BKC took nearly 2.5 decades to develop, while Wadala, which is an extension of that, is yet to develop despite being close to an expressway and having a monorail. So investors and home buyers looking at Kalyan should be prepared to stay invested in the long term to reap the benefits. From Mumbai, Nikhil Narayan Shivdas, NDTV.